Another sunny day, another video. Today I'm going to show you how to cut a plastic bucket with a handsaw. I'll be back right there. I bought these two buckets and I want to cut them to make wind turbine blades. First, I remove the handles. Right where the handle was, there is a hole. And at the bottom, I found the diameter end points. One here, one there. So using that diameter end point, I trace one line to this hole and I twist another line to the other hole. And as you can see, I already started to cut it. This one is how it is before I twist the hole. So I'll move on to show you how I cut it. I'll finish this cut and I'll start this one and finish it as well. Before we can cut it, we have to be able to put it in a position where it's stable to cut, where you can hold it so you can cut it with a straight cut. I use a bag that's filled with leaves to hold my plastic bucket. The bag is hugging the bucket and I'm going to approach the bucket with the saw and I'm going to cut. I can tell you right now that when I'm cutting, I will only be using the back stroke. If I use forward stroke, it will be very hard to cut. So the cut will be all done with back stroke. I insert the saw. Pressure on it. You can see my hand right there. And I use backstroke. Backstroke on it. If you go forward, you're looking for trouble. And I finish this side of the cut. I can even clean it up immediately. On this side anyway. Remove all the plastic buildup. I turn on the other side where there's already a line and I start the same process over. Back stroke on it. If you can't back up your car, I don't know. Because you have to back up all the way. Look at this bucket. Without adding additional work to yourself. You'll be tempted to go forward, but you have to stay back. That's the hard part, because there are all kind of support pieces under that lip. So you don't really know what you're cutting, but be patient. Once you bypass this area, the rest will be fairly easy. The hard part is to insert the saw from the beginning. All right. I can't even go forward, so I have to insert it all the way from back. This one's give me a little problem there because these things are not letting my saw go in, but I've been lifting this side. This time I'll lift this side, see if that gets easier. Here we go. One. Two. Three. Five, 8. 9. 10. I think 10 did it. Alright. Now we have to cut the bottom. I didn't trace it yet, but I will. Twist the line, kind of lean it towards the camera. There's a bump there, but we'll see if we can go past it. 1, 2, 3. Okay, am I seeing this right? Am I filming this right? Is it in the... Yeah, I can see everything. If I can see it, you can see it. I'm still not past 2, 3, 4, 5. Now I'm done with the bump. 6, 7, 8. Okay, now it's a question of inserting this thing, because the whole structure is collapsing. 9. 10. 11. 12. 13. 14. 15. 16. 17. 18. 19. 20, 21, 22, I'm in another bump, 24, 25, 26, 27, okay, at 27, it's cut. You see the burr? Let's see if we can remove some of that burr. Deburring 101, and this concludes your bucket cutting lesson for the day. Enjoy. You like the cost? Guess which windmill this is going into. That's right, I'm going to replace the black by this beautiful green. It's for you to find out if you don't already know. Bye bye. Just in case you missed the first step, I start with this bucket from scratch. I already removed the handle. I'm tracing a line. And once I trace that line, I will be cutting. Lines traced, extended. Okay. Now I'm ready to cut again. I start with the hard part where there's a that big old lip, and hopefully I'm not cutting right where there's a support plastic piece there, but here we go again. Stop, lean it there, back strokes only. This video will stop in a few seconds because I'm just cutting past the lip. 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. The odd part is inserting the blade in. 12. Anyways, I went way past the lip, a little deburring. Hey, deburred. Bye bye. See you later.